Hey, good morning. Happy Saturday. Hope you're off to a great start to your morning. Spend some time in prayer, meditation. Unless, of course, you have to take your pills this morning. I take mine at night. Still on the gabapentin for the nerve damage in my neck and shoulder. I fell during a 10-miler about, I don't know, 7-8 years ago. Knocked my neck and shoulder up pretty good, but that's not why I'm here. Today's takeaway, be wary of preachers who tend to bend to today's culture. We want to truly avoid that. Today's episode of GOTV is brought to you by, I'm having a hard time speaking this morning, Pennzoil. Remember, it's not just oil, it's Pennzoil. Seriously, I only use Pennzoil in my vehicles. A good friend of mine, I don't know, 15, 20 years back, he was a mechanic, and he just gave me the tip of always using Pennzoil. I get a new vehicle, be it new or used, take it to the shop, drain it, put Pennzoil in. We haven't had any engine problems, mechanical problems, but not engine problems. So remember, it's not just oil, it's Pennzoil. But I digress. Today's discussion, nothing yet, because a lot is still in bed. But yesterday, well, that really wasn't a discussion, but it was kind of funny. I've been watching The Office on Netflix, and I think she's slowly getting drawn into the dry humor of that show. But let me get to the task at hand today. It's kind of serious, could be kind of heavy, but please bear with me. I'm trying to maybe steer you away from some things. Last night, I'm looking for a movie to watch. I come across American Gospel. I'm like, what is this? But then when I saw that Alistair Begg was in it, he's the Truth for Life, Google Truth for Life, Alistair Begg. He's out of Cleveland, Ohio. Great messages. So check him out. In a nutshell, what this movie does, in my opinion, it takes a look at the effects of postmodernism on today's church and the manipulation of the gospel. So, an example, Stephen Furtick, I can't pronounce his name. He's a real high energy, muscle bound preacher. He's on, I think he has a show on Netflix, or, you know, he's around, big church, I think, down in Florida. He said, God broke the law for love. And of course, you know, that set off a lot of alarms and bells. For God to break the law, and you'll see this in the movie, that means that God sinned. And of course, we know that God does not sin. So God cannot break the law for love. I'm not banging on him. I don't watch him that much. But he did decline to take part in this documentary movie. So that kind of makes you wonder. Another guy, Richard Rohr, he appears, which is good. He's there to talk about his views, but to me, his views were questionable. Again, I think, you know, bending the gospel to fit his needs or his goals. They have clips of Oprah, who apparently left the church when she heard a preacher saying that God is a jealous God. She misunderstood that term or the definition of jealous with regards to the Lord. It is not our human definition. So I really encourage you. American Gospel, it's on Amazon Prime. One of the cool things that I learned yesterday watching the movie, you know, you see in the Bible, holy, holy, holy. What that really means is holy. Holier and holiest. Holy, holier and holiest. Where am I going with this? Please bear with me. Postmodernism is a huge threat to today's church. And I'm going to read to you from a book, a great book, Truth Decay by Douglas Gruheis. To counter this kind of abject aberration, preaching should be word-oriented as opposed to image-oriented. rational as opposed to merely emotional, transformational as opposed to trivial, and intellectually stimulating as opposed to merely entertaining or amusing. In other words, it must be countercultural, and must not bow to postmodernist trends. The God of Scripture, not the trends of postmodernity, must set the agenda for the church. God does not change. His word is true. And here's my final statements on this. I encourage you to find a church that is biblical, biblically based. Not every sermon that a preacher preaches should be happy feeling. Okay. They should make you think. They should make you sometimes feel convicted. They should make you yearn to draw nearer to God. Okay. To be like Christ. There is joy in Christ. There truly is joy in Christ. But we must be made aware, like I said yesterday, when I was talking about grace, every knee will bow. We will all be judged. I know it can be kind of hard to swallow, but don't you want that? Life isn't always happy-go-lucky. I mean, look at the situation we're in now. But be not afraid, be not afraid, be not afraid. We have the Lord's endless mercy, his endless grace, his endless forgiveness, but most importantly, his endless love. No matter what you've done, no matter what you are going through, he is there to pick you up, to lift you up. So I really encourage you to, after you watch the movie or sometime today, spend a good half hour to an hour studying your Bible. I recommend John, if not the Gospel of John, 1 John. It can truly be transformational. And that's what we want in our lives. We don't settle. Don't settle for where you're at. Okay? Because God has plans for you. He plans for you, plans for me to prosper. And we need to focus on that. I do appreciate your time. I truly, truly do. I'm going to switch over to crossmountain.church, and they have live prayer going on right now. It's probably too late. I'll have to catch it later when the recording's done. But then again, crossmountain.church, again, I don't speak for them, have their live services, I think, this afternoon, but it'll be available tomorrow. If you have any prayer requests or any kind of thing that you're going through, please feel free to reach out to me. Just DM me on the Facebook. Later today, look for a live message on my Stand With Me Please Ministries. I'm going to make an appeal for a church in Sierra Leone. They're going through some really tough times, especially with the COVID virus. So veterans and first responders, I hate to sound like a broken record, but please, 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 I beg of you. If you're going through something, or if you know of a veteran going through something, please point them to American Military Families UY6. Please, there's help out there. There are resources out there, and we'll do our best to take care of you. Again, thank you for your time. Hopefully, this is 8 minutes and 9 seconds well spent.